Long-standing racism against Japanese Americans erupted after Pearl Harbor into angry demands to force them to relocation camps during the war.
When the executive order 9066 was issued, that was the order that would forcibly remove anyone of Japanese ancestry. So that was 120,000 people up and down the West Coast to be put into a prison camp. There was this one man who disobeyed the military orders, and it ended up to be a landmark Supreme Court case called Korematsu versus the United States. Fred Korematsu was Japanese American. He was born in Oakland, California, so therefore he was an American citizen. He was paying attention the day that he was learning about the Constitution in high school. And so he thought he had rights as an American citizen. And he thought, you know, well, this is wrong. Why should he go to a prison camp when he had not violated any laws? And so my father disobeyed the military orders, and he was arrested about 30 days after everyone had to report to a detention assembly center in the San Francisco Bay Area.
At age 23, Mr. Fred Korematsu appealed his case all the way to the Supreme Court, which ruled against him at the time, arguing that incarceration was justified for military purposes. It took 74 years until that judgment was formally overruled in Trump v. Hawaii.
It happened a long time ago, and what he did, he thought was right, and the government was wrong. What he was doing was not just for himself, but was for his own Japanese American community. We all, at the end of the day, are human beings, and we all need to work together if we're going to make a difference, to find peace in this country. And that's what my father wanted. He crisscrossed this country like I do now to teach the lessons of history so that we don't keep making the same mistakes. People are still being racially profiled, religious profiled, and targeted. This hateful rhetoric, we need to stop. And it's got to stop with this generation, because we need to make people accountable. If I can't instill anything else in you, is to question. Is to question when you see something is wrong, to stand up for what is right, and don't be afraid to speak up. Just because you think they're in authority doesn't mean that they're getting it right. And it takes all of us collectively. That's our democracy. This is why I do this, because we need to uphold our civil liberties in the Constitution.